My name is Marie Rotter and I'm head of content strategy here in the Denver office. So content marketing has been getting a lot of buzz in the marketing industry right now. We work with a lot of clients that come to us that want to do a cohesive content strategy. And what we typically find is when people try to do this themselves, they get really excited about it and they start off with these great ambitions and maybe they post 3 blog posts a week and they're on Facebook and Twitter every day. And eventually they kind of run out of ideas. Then it's, you know, randomly posting work meetings, pictures on Facebook or job posts, and it kind of like starts petering out. You really can build a content strategy, whether you do it yourself or you work with an agency to do it. There are 4 things you want to consider. The first one is, you know what your core content is. So your website is a place where you want to attract visitors to your site and also returning customers. And you're trying to get them to learn more about what you do and how they can do business with you. It's a very straightforward message. The second thing you wanna do is look for influencers. Those could be bloggers, those could be people that have video blogs. They could be trade publications within your industry. They could be analysts in your industry that have their own personal blogs. And what you really wanna do is reach out to them, look for people that have, you know, the most likes, comments, mentions, and start reaching out to them with valuable content. So your website is really the hub of information of where people can do business with you. The spoke of the wheel, if we're gonna make a metaphor of this, is your content that will drive people back to your website. So the spokes go out to the different influencers in your market, and then your content drives them back to your website. The third thing that you wanna do, and I see a lot of companies struggling with this, is you wanna go into a very specific problem that you know your audience has and go very deep into that problem. What I see a lot of content doing is kind of an overview, like 10 things you can do with business intelligence. So what you end up doing is keeping it really high level. And so there's not a lot of value in that information. And so what you want to do is really just focus on one thing and make it go deep into that subject and explain why it works, what the problem is, how you define the problem, what value you bring or what value they can find in the market. Maybe that's your product. It's not a pitch for your product. It's not a sales message, but it's definitely defining, you know, I understand you. I know what your problems are, and this is how you can solve it. The last thing you want to do is make sure that you're very organized in how you put together your content strategy. It's really good if you can map out content and figure out, you know, what are your channels? So are you going to be on Facebook? Are you going to be on Instagram or not? Where do you decide that you need to be? And this can be defined by where your audience is and also what your resources are. You don't have to blog every day, but you need to be consistent about what you're doing. The other thing you want to think about is as you put your message out there, you know, not everybody likes to read blog posts, not everybody likes to watch videos. So take the same message and duplicate it across your different deliverables. If you're doing an ebook, take part of that information and make it into an infographic. You don't have to reinvent the wheel every time you're ready to make a new piece of content. What we're saying in all this is that you want your website to help people understand who you are and what you do. And you want your content to help people understand how you can help them. Bringing these 2 ideas together, you can really create a content marketing strategy that drives word of mouth and increases your brand exposure and increases referrals and leads. How have you found ways to increase engagement online? Or are there things that you're really struggling with in your content strategy? Leave a comment below. Also, you can check out our other blog posts online for more helpful information on digital marketing.